हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम एडवोकेट भाग्यश्री भोसले। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी शैल डिस्कस अबाउट द प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ अ वुमेन अंडर द कन्वेंशन ऑन द एलिमिनेशन ऑफ ऑल फॉर्म्स ऑफ अ डिस्क्रिमिनेशन अगेंस्ट द वुमेन। द कन्वेंशन ऑन द एलिमिनेशन ऑफ ऑल फॉर्म्स ऑफ अ डिस्क्रिमिनेशन अगेंस्ट वुमेन वॉज एडॉप्टेड बाई द यूनाइटेड नेशंस जनरल असेंबली ऑन डिसम्बर 1979. It came into force on September 3, 1981. After the required number of states ratified it, today more than 100 countries, including India, proud signatory to this convention. Family referred to as a CEDAW means CEDAW. India joined the convention on July 13, 1980, and ratified it on July 9, 1990. The unique contribution of this convention often acknowledged as the Magna Carta of the Women's Right or International Bill of a Right of a Woman is that it bring into focus one half of the humanity which was hitherto designed of a footing of a equality with other half. The CEDAW spells out the real meaning of a gender equality and lays down that in a various ways in which it can be achieved. It provides an action agenda to be followed by its all signatory is to achieve the notion of a equality. All the countries which are a parties to CEDAW have given the undertaking to put its provision into the practice in their respective country. Every such a country is also bound to submit a national report at least once in every 5 years specifying the steps taken by it to comply with the provision of a CEDAW. In a span of a 30 article of a CEDAW to abolish all forms of a discrimination against the women and thus usher the in an area of a true gender equality. Interestingly, it is only international convention that affirm the reproductive right of a woman and target culture and tradition as a influential forces that shape a gender roles and family relations. The first comprehensive treaty addressing the women's right, the convention on elimination of all forms of discrimination against the women, we can say CEDAW, in a short, provide a universal declaration of a discrimination against a woman. The primary goal of a CEDAW is to eliminate the discrimination against women and to promote the rule of a law and respect for a human right around the world. It obligate the state parties to condemn the discrimination in all forms and to ensure a legal framework that provide the protection against the discrimination and embody the principle of equality. The treaty address such issues as education, employment, health, care, protection, property ownership and human trafficking. CEDAW provide a globally agreed upon a legal framework for the protection and promotion of a basic human right for the women. Signatory countries can use CEDAW as a guideline or a guide in establishing law and policy to ensure equal protection of the law in areas of a society for a women and girls. Although 188 countries have ratified the convention, the main objective of a CEDAW are as follows: to establish the principle of equality between men and women, to abolish the discriminatory laws, to make appropriate laws prohibiting the discrimination against the women, to establish a tribunals and other institutions to ensure the effective implementation and protection of a woman's right against all kind of a discrimination, to end all act of a discrimination against a woman by person, organization and the enterprises. It also clarified that nothing in the convention is to affect any provision which is more conducive to the achievement of a equality between men and women. Contained in the legislation of a member state or in any other international convention, treaty, agreement in force in a member state. By accepting the convention, CEDAW, member states commit themselves to fulfill the main objective of the CEDAW to take all necessary measures at a national level to achieve the full realization of her rights conferred on a woman by the convention. In a particular, the member state agree to undertake a series of measures to end the discrimination against women in all forms. CEDAW contain a 30 article. The summary of a article as follows. Article 1, definition of a discrimination. Discrimination against women include any distinction, exclusion or a restriction that affect the woman's enjoyment of a political, economical, social, cultural, civil or any other right on a equal basis with a man. Articles 2 state that policy measures state must make the laws and regulations, implemented policies and change practices to eliminate the discrimination against the women. Equality of women are fundamentally equal with the men in all spheres of her life. State should take action to ensure women can enjoy the basic human right and fundamental freedom. The temporary, then Article 4 state that temporary special measures, affirmative action or a temporary special measure should and can be used to accelerate the women's equality. Article 5 states that sex role and stereotyping. The convention recognizes the influence of a culture and tradition in restricting the woman's enjoyment of her rights. State must modify or abolish the discriminatory cultural practices and take the appropriate measures to eliminate sex roles, stereotyping and prejudice stemming from the idea of a inferiority or a superiority of a one sex over the other. Article 6 of the CEDAW state that trafficking and prostitution. State parties must take all the measures including legislation to stop all forms of trafficking and exploitation of a woman for the prostitution. Article 7 states that political and public life, women have an equal right to vote, hold public office and participate in a civil society. Article 8 of the said convention states that participation of the international level, women should be able to represent their country internationally and work with the international organization on an equal basis with the men. Article 9, nationality, women have an equal right with the men to acquire change or to retain their nationality and that of their children. Article 10 states that equal right in the education, women have an equal right to educating including the vocational training, guidance, continuing the education, sports, scholarship. The content of the curriculum should prevent the repetition of a negative stereotype and sexual health education should be available for a men and women. Article 11, employment. Women have the right to work, employment opportunity, equal remuneration, free choice of a profession and employment, social security and the protection of a health. Discrimination of the grounds of a marriage. Discrimination on the grounds of a marriage, pregnancy, childbirth and child care is a prohibited. Article 12 states that health care and family planning. Women have an equal right to access a health care including the sexual health, family planning services and pre and post natal care. Article 30 of the said convention state that women have the equal right to family benefits, financial credit and to participate in a recreational activities, sports and cultural life. Article 14 of the said convention state that the rural women, regarding the rural women have the right to adequate living condition, participation in a development planning and access to the education, healthcare, transport and financial services. आर्टिकल 15 ऑफ द सेड कन्वेंशन स्टेट दैट द इक्वेलिटी बिफोर लॉ. वुमेन आर टू बी ट्रीटेड एज अ इक्वल बिफोर द लॉ. वुमेन हैव द लीगल राइट टू एंटर अ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट, ओन अ प्रॉपर्टी एंड चूज वेयर टू लिव. आर्टिकल 16 स्टेट द प्रोविजन रिगार्डिंग द मैरिजेस एंड फैमिली. वुमेन हैव अ इक्वल राइट विद द मैन विद इन द मैरिज इंक्लूडिंग फैमिली प्लानिंग, प्रॉपर्टी ओनरशिप एंड ऑक्यूपेशन. देन इन आर्टिकल 17-20 Article 17 to Article 22 state that these articles set up the committee of the elimination of a discrimination against the women. We can say that the CEDAW committee to review that progress has been made by the countries. These articles say how the committee work. And Article 23 to 30 of this convention state that the administration state the provision regarding the administration and management of the convention. These articles say how the United Nations and governments should work together to make a sure right of a girls and women are protected. The article also says that the disagreement between the government about the girls and women's right can be settled. In this way, the CEDAW is a very important international convention for elimination of all forms of discrimination of against the women and girls. And India is one of the signatory member of this convention. Thank you.